it for IPL. Any questions?
Well, that's you don't have another 10 minutes?
Well, actually, I do want some other stuff. So for IPL, if that's all okay for right now.
How come you went with, I mean, 26 available letters except for the R for the Jaguar and the M for the BMW? And the,
oh, why?
Why this why? Particular, why didn't you pick out some other single
letter? Single letter.
That you could have popped under the deck.
Yeah, I think we didn't want to go directly to, like, you know, we're not trying to copy what other brands have done. It was the idea here was to set ourselves apart a little bit and do something a little different. Because, yeah, you know, you can, the M badge is the one that I'm, you know, everyone's familiar with. So rather than, you know, it's, we're not trying to copy and make it an M3, you know, an Infiniti version of the M3. And that was a conscious decision to not go directly and say, this is what we want to be like. The idea here was to separate ourselves a little bit.
Which is more like an $80,000 car.
Yeah, I was being generous. So.
So you've got this vehicle, you're trying to bring it in under 50.
Mm-hmm.
You know, here's the hard question. How many real hand raisers are there out there for something like that at this time?
Well, and that's a good, you know, with the economy as it is, that's a good question. And that's the question that will be determined once it goes on sale. But based on the feedback from our dealers and from our customers, there's a fair number of people out there that want this type of car. And that price point really makes it attractive to them. They're not ready to go to a $70,000 car, but they wouldn't mind going to a $50,000 car that gives them something that's a little bit more unique.
How much of a bump is that over the journey, over the 37 journey?
Comparably equipped, it's about a $5,500 difference. We went yesterday and did the math, but yeah, it's about a $5,500 difference.
Are there any options?
Just the colors.
Just the colors?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, transmissions. Automatic or manual, and then the colors. That's it.
Are the transmissions geared any differently than them?
No.
Interesting.
What do you think, the take rate of the manual is going to be?
Yeah, that's one we've been debating for a while, because what we're finding is manual transmissions are just flat disappearing. There are fewer and fewer people that are willing to step up for a manual. This is something Larry and I go around and around on, because I like manual transmissions, and Larry does too, personally. But he also sees the data that it's hard to get people to buy them. So I don't know if we have a projection on take rate of the manual. It's a good question. I'll need to find out, and I'll get back to you.
What's going to be the focus for your marketing and ad campaign?
Very low-key operation.
low volumes mean low ad dollars, so I'm sure it'll probably get included with some of the brand stuff that's out there, but I doubt that you'll see specific IPL-focused advertising.
Is this kind of a trial balloon? If this does work, will there be more?
No, the plan is that it's a line, that there'll be other IPL products coming down the road.
But this might show you whether it's worth doing more or how many.
I'm sure that it'll have an impact on how many are planned down the road. I'm sure there are, you know, with the lead times we have on stuff.
This one bombs, you may say, well, let's do something else next time.
Yeah, they may shift the focus a little bit, but the plan is that it's a line that you'll have multiple versions of IPL products and within Infiniti.
So in essence, this is Infiniti's version of an SVT.
Well, it's a unique subset of our models. I don't know that I want to compare it to other manufacturers. You know, their brands of doing those things. But yeah, it's a something that sets us apart within the overall Infiniti lineup. Anything else?
Winning lottery number?
Hats. The other thing is, today out here, I've got some boards out here that talk about some of the technologies that are available on the products. One in particular that I don't know if you've gotten a chance to drive, the QX56, but we've got two of them out here, and they have the hydraulic body motion control on it. The those vehicles don't have any anti-roll bars. They have a hydraulic system that keeps the body level, and it keeps it surprisingly level going around corners. So those are there if you want to drive them. If you have any questions about the how that system works, I can talk about that. We also, with the new M's out here, have a blind spot intervention on those, and if you want to do a demonstration of that, we can do that, where it actually, in addition to noticing that there's a vehicle in the blind spot and setting up a warning light, it also will intervene and actually apply the brakes on the opposite side to sort of tug the vehicle back into the center of the lane. Four-wheel active steer is available on the M as well, and those we have those here. Can talk about that. The other one that we've had for a little while that I don't think many people are aware of is a distance control assist technology that actually, you don't have to have cruise control set, but if you're in traffic and have this on, it'll actually push back on the throttle to let you know that you're getting close to the vehicle ahead of you, to let you know you want to get off the throttle. And once you lift off the throttle, it'll actually apply the brakes and slow you down so you don't get too close to the car ahead. And if the car ahead of you stops, it'll actually bring the car to a stop. And it's something we can demonstrate. It does it without the cruise control being on. So it's a pretty cool technology. That's out here as well. And the other one that's sort of interesting is that we have the eco pedal on the M that is here. There's a knob on the center console of the M where you can select different drive modes, sport, standard, eco, and snow. And in eco mode, the eco pedal will actually assist you in getting better fuel economy. It'll push back. If you get aggressive with the throttle, it'll actually push back on the throttle and say, you may want to ease up if you want to get better gas mileage. So that's out here as well. So if you have any questions and want to drive those and want to do a demonstration of the distance control assist or the blind spot intervention, we can set that up. So that's all I had. If you have any questions on any of the technologies, I'll be here all day to talk through it. And the way that... What's that?
Try the wheel.
Tip your server.
Please tip your server.